The buffer crop farmers model is a practical and innovative solution to protect crops from wild animal damage. Based on ecological principles and agriculture innovation, this model also emphasizes the strategic planting of specific crops or vegetation around farmlands to create a buffer zone. Researchers from private universities spearheaded the research on this model, which has been launched today in Kampala. According to Dr. Taddewo Rusoke, a lead researcher from Mkumba University, this research will mostly help farmers bordering national parks who have often been in conflict with wild animals which destroy their crops. Buffer crops are unique in a way that they can't be eaten, neither can they be destroyed by wild animals.
For crop farming against wild animal damage in Uganda, and this book provides solutions on how farmers living around protected areas such as national parks, wildlife reserves in Uganda and maybe Africa at large, on how they can grow crops which are not damaged by wild animals. And some of these crops, such as tea, they will help farmers create a buffer between the protected area land and community land. And in the process of animal movement, as animals move out of the protected area to feed, they will encounter these buffer crops. When the animals encounter buffer crops, they will try to forage on the buffer crops. They will find these crops are not palatable.
Wildlife, as an institution mandated to manage the country's wildlife resources, has promised to base on this research to sensitize farmers around protected areas about the value of planting buffer crops. Buffer crops include coffee, tea, simsim, among others.
Life in form of animals and plants. Most of this wildlife is found in area protected areas or outside protected areas. So it is the responsibility of every Ugandan to play a key role in conserving what God gave us in terms of plants and animals. Unfortunately, there are people who are degrading environment habitats for this wildlife, which is very unfortunate. We pray and we are working hard to change people's attitudes and minds so that they value environment and wildlife.
It's at this point that private university researchers expressed a need for the government to consider extending more research funds to private institutions. The argument is that good research can influence policy formulation of the country as well as help come up with new innovations to improve people's lives at the grassroots.
Government is research funding is very critical for the entire country. They've provided research funds for public universities and not allowed private universities access to them. My call is they should open up and allow the private institutions to do research from these funds.
There are opportunities out there which researchers can take advantage of. However, we are saying, especially like for us who are working in private universities, maybe the government could channel some funds which can help researchers in private universities to do more research, collect evidence which can support government.
Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.